Let's take a closer look at some aspects of her record. We won't be able to cover it all, but for example, police body-worn cameras. She said, this was as Attorney General, that generally speaking, she supported that, but she did not believe that the state should force municipalities to take that step. In other words, that local governments should decide whether or not that works for them. How did you view that positioning on that issue?
So at the time that debate was happening, we were having very high profile police shootings of young Black men. And there had been one in particular, Stephen Clark in Sacramento. There was a lot of outrage and a real push for more accountability. What she was trying to do, I think, was strike this balance by acknowledging all of the outrage and pain in the community and saying, yes, I'm going to mandate this for the Attorney General's office, but I'm not going to take that further step of mandating it for everyone. And I think to some people, including the Black Legislative Caucus, that was a disappointment. At the time, it was a very sort of smart on crime, centrist, democratic position to take. Of course, now we're in a completely different era.